Hello, hello. Suddenly a white Yosha appears, doing a random programming stream. Which wasn't... it's not really random. Good evening, Chick. I hope you all had a great day. What's on the list for today? We will pretty much just do implementation part 2 of the multi-sprite atlas. Fix the to-dos we added last time and actually fix the sprite picking. As far as I still remember, the last time we got it pretty much working, but it's still missing some stuff. Well, it's wrong way around. I'm real low. Should I just speak louder? I can also I can't really increase my my mic. Nope, guess I just have to talk louder. Hope it's fine this way. Yeah, I'm gonna try to speak a little louder, but I can't really pull up too much now. Thanks, Chick. So the problem pretty much is having the Atlas build up the wrong way around. Unity is, wants to build up from the... Unity is using bottom left as the 0-0 position. We are using top left as 0-0 position. That's not gonna work. So let's turn that around. Child right is still gonna be the same, since left and right force is the same. We use left, Unity uses left. The problem really is just we use top position versus Unity using the bottom left as pivot. So we pretty much just have to switch child bottom to child top. And remaining bottom is also gonna be remaining top. So instead of adding, let's get the good old paint up. Instead of adding pictures to the bottom and calculating the rest here and here, we will be adding pictures on the bottom left and calculating rest here and rest here, which means the right part is always gonna be the same, right? Calculations for the right are still correct. The most calculations for the rest here will still be correct. We will just need to adjust where the position of the sprites actually are. In this case, we can just change the method, set remaining, and just rename it. See the top width remaining. So instead of having to calculate from this point on. We now calculate this part, which is still going to be the same calculation. It's still going to be tree width by tree height, or the node we are currently looking at, and tree height minus the node height. That's still correct. Which means we really just need to change it, honestly. Remaining top. Remaining top. And remaining top. And we have child top. So the child still has pretty much the same calculations. It's still the remaining top x, negative the node size, node width, for the width, and still the node height for its new height. All of this is still correct. Wonderful. So we don't actually have to change too much to just turn it around, and it should just work. But we are programming, so it's probably not gonna work as is. And shut up. And can't fit bottom, that's gonna be remaining top. And remaining top, and probably rename this one to can't fit. So checking the top is still gonna be correct. In height, the new node height must be smaller than the remaining size in Y, which is the height, and the width must be smaller than X, which is width. That's perfect. Let's see, do I have any safe loaded? Nope. Perfect. Testing it is. Already creating two atlases. Yeah, it's still doing something wrong. That doesn't look particularly right. Let's see. I'm probably not correctly assigning the positions, copying the positions. Yeah, I'm still trying to use a unity position. The unity position is now wrong. We just use a position. The position is set via set position. And in this case, let's see. When we add a new child to the right. Let's say we add it like this. Okay, first off, the main child is always 0,0. Which is still correct. But our 0,0 is top left. Actually, it's arbitrary, so we can use whatever we want. We just need to set the remaining ones correctly. Let's see, position. If we add a new child to the right, the new position is our current position, so 0,0, plus the width of the current child. That's fine. This one is add it to that position. And y is still going to be the same, so 0. For child top, it's going to be the same. So let's say we add one like this. In this case, the position x is going to be the same. It's not going to change. And the y is the current y, so in this case 0 plus the height of the node we'll add to. So that's fine. Let's see if it's just using the wrong position. Hey Kyle! Hope you're doing better in programming than I'm currently doing. Stuff is not really working out on our side, but hey, that's what we're here to fix. That's definitely looking better, it's still looking wrong. And I'm wondering why. Yeah, I know why. I know why it's wrong. Turns out order by is gonna order ascending, not descending. Which means the biggest sprite, I just circled the smallest sprite. The biggest sprite is going to be the first one, the last one, not the first one. Which is an easy fix, we just need to say the order by descending. We want the biggest sprite to be the first one to be added. At least it's better than last week. Well, yeah. But to be fair, we got all day for today for fixes and debugging. Last week we still had to write this whole tree system. Not all day you'll write a binary tree, but if you want to do some exercise, definitely go ahead and implement the binary tree. You can use it for a lot of stuff, including creating an atlas. Yeah, this is looking better. It's not perfect yet, but it's looking way, way better. The interesting part is why some stuff is not fitting to the right. But that should be an easy fix. Like, these tiles are the same size. So they should all fit to the right of each other. And these ones should too. They should be next to each other. This one should be right here. Which probably is an easy fix. It's just I'm just not comparing the sizes correctly. Let's see. The can't fit functions. Yeah, if it's equal, it's okay too. I always, in this case, I'd set if the sprites are both of the same size, it wouldn't fit. But that's fine totally to us. Let's see. I'm 99% sure this one is probably correct. Yeah, This is looking much better. You can even see the hangers are all correctly added to the bottom now. And I think it's only making one atlas. Never mind. Why is this single image on the second atlas? Actually, is it? Okay, yeah, never mind. This one was created 15 minutes past 9, and this one was created 30 minutes past 9. So if we delete both, we'll probably get the correct result. Let's see. It only created one atlas. Wonderful. There you go. Custom atlas sprite picker. Now to fix issues. So the tree system is completely working. We are completely fine with it, and it's doing perfectly what we want. Really sad we wanted to watch football last time. We could have fixed it so quick. Anyway. Going back the wrong way around, this is the wrong pivot. This is the one we just fixed. Let's commit that. By the way, I'm using some shortcuts like ST for status. And also git fetch actually. It's just git status and git fetch in one comment. Clean is just removing a bunch of files that aren't necessary. In this case, all the sprite atlases that are made by the game sometimes are repacked and always want to be committed to. We are just removing them and so not to commit them all the time. In this case, this is the correct status we want to see. Only the sprite picker changed, so we commit it. As long as it's only modified, it's not staged technically, but my CM comment is just short for commit, will stage all files and commit them. So it's just stage and commit with the message I'm going to give here. In this case, fixed sprite picking. Pivot to be bottom left. Perfect. Now let's see. Kyle, while you're here, is your mod with the vehicle stuff still up? And is it still using airplanes, or is it still putting airplanes on the sprite atlas? That'd be perfect way to test out if we can add a secondary atlas. Actually, if it's making a secondary atlas if the first one is filled up. Okay, this one is pretty easy now. The UVs are really easy to set since we are now complying pretty much with the same standard Unity is doing. We can just easily set all of them and that's it. Go ahead, we can use them. Probably not gonna work this the first time, but let's see. Graham Taylor, how long? At least an hour and a half now. I'm probably gonna stream at least 2 hours, maybe longer, if you mean the stream length. Hi Ryan, thanks for coming out. I hope it's not too dry for you guys. Hope you're doing some other stuff and not just listening to me programming. But I'm happy you guys are out watching this video, or if you're live out here with me, watching me program. Anyway, UV, we have to also set them. to the atlas texture. New texture 2D, we look at all nodes. And yeah, node dot atlas texture dot UVs. Do I not have a thing for that? No, I don't. Let's see, atlas creator, the old one. How are you setting that? Ah, it's set on the texture itself, which is fine. I still have to create the sprite also. No, that's an atlas texture. Ah, dot rect. Rect. Dot rect is equal to UV. And since this is way too simple, we can simplify it to inline. Now we also have to create the sprite, which I'm just gonna steal this method from the Atlas creator. This is just a method to automate sprite creating in Unity. We want a specific sprite, but most of this stuff is pretty much always given. Or it's always the same. We really only need a couple of things changed. The atlas is always must always be given. The the new rectangle must be given. And the name must be given. I'm actually gonna small this function down. That sounds weird. I'm gonna make it easier. I'm just gonna pass an atlas texture, which already has the information of the rectangle, so the UVs, and the name of the sprite. Ah, lovely, and the end of the once changed, we will probably or anyway replace the old Atlas creator. And at that point we can remove the whole class and just use this CS file for the Atlas rect and Atlas texture. Currently they are split up. Now the pixel rect is going to be Atlas texture. Dot rect, and it's going to be atlas texture dot position. We have a position. What does the rect have a position? Rect atlas texture dot rect dot position. Nope. I know why. So the sprite create function needs a rect, and the rect, the unity.rect itself has a position, but the atlas rect, the custom struct we have, does not have it, which means we have to convert it. So we can just say var pixel rect is equal to atlas texture dot rect, and since it, we have to convert it, cast it, we just say rect. And in this case we have an implicit operator which can convert it. In both directions, rect to atlas rect and atlas rect to rect, and it just returns the new object of each other. This makes it a little bit easier. We just say pixelRect, pixelRect.position, pixelRect.size. Pixels per unit is a given constant, it's 64. That's consistent throughout the game. Then we say zero extrude, because we always have the fixed sprite, and it's always rectangle. And since it's always rectangular, we just say full rect for the mesh type. Sprite name, set that. It's it's gonna be atlas texture.name. I'm using that throughout. Now, so we set the atlas texture rect. Now we also set the node atlas texture.sprite to create sprite. Now we need the atlas. The atlas is gonna be the node.atlas. We need some reference to the atlas probably. Or I'm just using the atlas texture, which also has a reference to the tree, the atlas texture. But let's see, the tree, or it's the tree does not contain any reference for the texture. So each node has the texture, so with the content which it saves. But the whole tree does not have an atlas texture, the overall thing, which is not a problem. I'm just gonna use node.atlasTexture. I think sprite. Texture, get the reference to this, to the used texture. If packed, this will point to the atlas. Perfect. Even since we are packing manually, this should be fine. Let's see. I think I'm actually doing the same over here. Loaded atlas, atlas texture, atlas texture is well. Okay, in this case, I'm since this is packing the texture onto a texture. Packing the sprites onto a texture, it has to do this. Like, I have to have a texture that is used for the atlas texture, which I then can use. But this should work fine. And then the node.atlas texture for all the rest of the information. Then let's also do some testing. I'm always having the atlas texture do some calculations on how fast it is. You can also do this here on the new sprite packer. And I know you shouldn't be using daytime now and comparison for like speed critical stuff. But since we are the creation of the atlas actually takes some time, it's okay to be used in this case. It's just less precise if you have really, really, really low milliseconds or nanoseconds type of speed. In this case, we can reliably test within milliseconds, and so it's not a problem. Mod atlas generated, let's say new system mod atlas grid generated. Let's also say force is always true. Actually, you can just say that force is true up here. So the thing is gonna regenerate automatically. So we perfectly have a performance comparison between the two. Let's see. Yeah, let's test actually. And it didn't work.
Let's see, object reference not instance in an object.
Yeah, well, yeah, this is not gonna work. So the problem is our node Atlas texture sprite. What if we want to set the sprite, we need the Atlas, but we're currently trying to get the Atlas from the sprite, so that's never gonna work. The sprite is null at this point. Which means the tree has to save some data per tree. Not gonna add a dictionary for it, I'm just gonna add it to the tree class. So let's say prop. We'll be saving a texture 2D, which is going to be the Atlas. Simple but effective. And we will be requiring it. Texture 2D. And it's going to be texture. Atlas. Atlas. Atlas equals to Atlas. Now we have two errors. Once this new tree is generated, and this tree is generated. Actually, it's not the best idea to do this. Let's see, we're only generating the texture for each tree down here. Well, honestly, we can also just generate it earlier. That's not gonna be a problem. Yeah, let's just generate it while building the Atlas anyway. And down here too. And now we have tree dot Atlas. It worked perfectly. Now let's see. The Atlas Atlas is always created first, and currently we are taking a bit more time, but not by much. Can probably still optimize this stuff down, and we are still able to create multiple atlases, not like Unity. If we try to use the Unity system with brute force or some other way, trying to check out which atlas works, it would probably be way slower. And less than 1 second in speed is still fine for me. As long as we're below like double time for the same amount of textures, we're pretty happy. Question now. Next part, texture util. This needs some optimization. Optimization and iteration. Currently, the problem is this would allocate a lot. If we do it pixel by pixel, we allocate less, which is good. Less allocation, it means less garbage collection. But we also have to do it pixel by pixel, so we need two for each. Well, two fours. One for X and the source width. And one for Y with the source height. And then it's just destination dot set pixel, one single pixel. At X plus destination X, Y plus destination Y, and the color is gonna be source dot get pixel, only one, X comma Y. This will probably not change the speed overall, but it's gonna be at least less allocation heavy. Let's see if it's gonna change the speed anything at all. So the new system took about 850 milliseconds last time. The sprite pack of Unity took like 500 milliseconds. Let's see what's doing now. This is way slower, which I really don't like. That's some big trade-off time for less allocation on load. Well, we can also further optimize it by using graphics.copy texture, which I'm just gonna implement real quick. Unity graphics. Copy texture. Also, don't question me why my DuckDuckGo is on German. I'm actually using the whole system on English, even though I'm in Germany. It's probably thinking that I'm just in Germany. But whatever. It's working out fine. Unity scripting API. Graphics.copy texture. So the problem with this is that it's not supported everywhere. But the good thing about it is the documentation is completely wrong. It's stating that Metal and WebGL currently do not have texture copy support. Metal is used for anything on macOS, but Arthur is actually using macOS. And I wrote with him about this. He told me the copy texture support is enabled, it's there. So I have no idea what why the documentation still states it is not. Which means I can probably use it for most systems. DirectX 3D9, like DirectX, pretty much any system supports DirectX. It can't copy 3D textures, but that's not really an issue. And we are not copying from texture to render texture. That's not a problem either. We are just copying from texture to texture. OpenGL's fine. Some older OpenGL cards may not be able to run it, so they will be running the slow system. The point is, most systems are working with it, but some older may fall back to the best Windows feature ever. Some may fall back to the system. Let's see, lost my tab there. Go. Perfect. This one is systeminfo.copy texture support. Private static wood copy texture. New, let's say modern. I'm just gonna declare some functions real quick. Private static void copy texture legacy. And I'm just gonna clean this up. That's not gonna work. That's gonna work. And we pretty much just need the same signature. So in this case, we will be using the graphics.copy texture here, and only if it works, and in any other case we can use the legacy mod. So if systeminfo.texturecopy, copy texture support equals dot if it's copy 3D, it's fine. Different types is fine. This is fine. This is so pretty much only if it's none. We should use a copy to texture legacy. And we just pass everything as a one-to-one. Make it a little more fancy. Else, copy texture modern. DST, SRC, DSTX, DSTY. Now let's real quick implement it. This shouldn't be too hard. It's just graphics.copy texture. This is a bit annoying to set destination. You pretty much have to use this long, the third override of it. Just gonna real quick put this over chat, actually over Discord chat, so I can still see you guys writing in YouTube, which I'm not getting not any notifications for. Discord is fine, Slack is fine, I'm getting notifications for that. At least I'm getting dots in the bottom of my screen. I cannot see you writing you if I have something over the YouTube chat. So this one should be just be graphics.copyTexture, and then we want to use this one. So the source is going to be source. That should be zero for us. The source map is going to be 0 for us too. Source x is going to be 0 too. Source y 2. Source width is going to be source.width. That's going to be source.height. That's going to dst. That's 0, 0. And dstx and dsty. I really love how I pretty much just accidentally have chosen the same naming scheme as Unity always did. That was totally not on purpose. Fencing it up with making it a one-liner. Beautiful. Should work out of box. Let's see. Graphics copy texture. If we have the copy texture for support, let's debug lock. Copied texture using modern, using graphics. Let's see how this is performing in terms of speed. Probably a bit faster, but let's see. Yeah, definitely. Let's see, it should, yeah, here, copy texture using graphics 18 times, so all of the textures were copied with a new system, and I'm like 99% sure that Unity is using the same system now. This small little bit of a difference is probably just to us some slowdowns in our side of the code. So this is working fine, and this can be thrown out. Texture utils is finished, sprite backer. Now, what do we have to do left besides committing once? That is fine, that is fine, that's all fine. CM. Improved texture utils copy texture. Perfect. Now we've got writing, but we still need to see. We have to do two things now. The main concern is that we don't want to create all the texture atlases all the time. Which means we need to save the current state we generated, and afterwards we need to load it and check if the state is the same or is would be the same as if we just created a new atlas or new atlases. The old atlas creator did this first, and only if it differed, it used the new system, created a new atlas. We'll be probably doing the same here. To save it, to save the atlas, there has to be two things. We have to save the atlas itself, which we created. This is fine. We are already doing it. We are already looking at it. Over here, this is the new atlas, working perfectly fine there. I'm always trying to close it, but I want this one open. Now we also have to save the tree for this specific atlas, or just all trees in general. So we could just save the list of tree, which is probably going to be the easiest solution. So let's say once the all atlases have been wrote, we want to say file.write all text. That's all bytes, write all text. And we'll be writing it to the atlas rect path. And it's going to be the JSON convert dot serialize object. We'll just be using JSON to serialize it. I also used it for the old atlas creator and it's working pretty fine. Means we can just really simply load it up again. Let's test that real quick. Once Unity responds. One small annoyance with Unity is always having to wait for it to recompile. I could probably disable recompilation on script change, but that'd be annoying too, because you'd have to manually recompile it, or tell Unity to recompile everything. So let's stay with that. That didn't work out. Let's see why. I need to copy some. Ah, never mind. Let's see. Yeah, I think I know why. So in this case, it's saving. Ah, yeah. Okay. Problem. JSON as is doesn't like serializing most of the Unity types. In this case, sprite is an issue, and texture2d actually. Why is it an issue? Well, if you take a look at vector2, you will find that there's somewhere going to be a reference loop. That's perfectly what Newtons of JSON is going throwing here in the exception. It's a self-referencing loop. Now, how do we fix it? In this case, it's already fixed. Texture2d and sprite are both ignored. JSON ignore, so they will not be serialized. But we didn't add this to the atlas, to the tree itself, which we're just gonna be doing. JSON ignore, so the texture2d is not saved, which we cannot and we don't want to save. We want to load it. And I'm probably fine over here. Vector2 ints are maybe a problem. But we don't have to actually save them. Yeah, the atlas texture already has everything we need. Test rect, test the. Yeah, we only need the rect to create and recreate the sprite on load. So we're totally fine not saving anything past the atlas texture. nodes need to be saved, so we have the tree still built up. So we make this way we make sure that we actually have all of them saved, all of the Atlas rects, all of the Atlas textures. But yeah, the vector to ints don't have to be saved. We've not been using them if you load it. Perfect. This should save now. And I'm using the same file name, so in this case we will not actually see two files like Atlas 0 and no and the old Atlas. We're just this one is just overwritten. And one liner, which makes sense. By default, JSON does not fancy it up. So let's fancy it up by saying view and appearance. Oh, never mind, add this word verb. So this is our Atlas as pure information, showing us what the Atlas contains and where it is. But we save a couple of things in this case, and it's perfectly fine, perfectly saved in this case. We have the list, brackets are always list, curly brackets, and the curly brackets indicate one of the nodes. Actually, this one might be the old one. Let's see. Yeah, I'm actually not over. I'm overwriting the new system with the old system. So let's just say Atlas rect new.json. Should be a little bit different since it's a list of three and nodes are going to be contained in it too. See? This is the old one, this is the new one. Alt-Z. And yeah, this is looking way different. Now you can perfectly see the binary tree here, by the way, child right, child right, child right. And at some point we will be having a child top. Yeah, there you go. Child tops all the way. And the lowest child never has anything that's null. Null is fine, we ignore it. But the most furthest child right has an Atlas texture, which is this one, some hanger made by Modair. And so we have the path, which also means we have the name. The name is always just the name of the file without the extension. And we have the rect. And from pretty much these two things, from the name and the rect, technically only from the rect, the name is just some additional information, but pretty much just from the rect we can recreate the sprite. Then we also have the last file change, and combining path and the last file change together, we can pinpoint if anything changed. If either the file name changed, so it's a new file name or file name not yet on the Atlas, or the last file changed, meaning the file has changed, we will be rebuilding the Atlas. One thing to note here, we do not have major information on the root node. We only have root, which is the main tree. Root is the root node on the tree, and then you have a bunch of nodes, and at the end you have tree width and tree height. This is a bit of a problem because we also would like to know which atlas this one is referring to. So let's say also save the atlas ID. And this one is just gonna be auto-generated. So we have a private static int atlas id, actually next atlas id is equal to 0, which I don't have to specify, so that's fine. And when we call the constructor, we just say atlas id equals to next atlas id plus plus. So the first ID is gonna be 0, and then we will be increasing it, since plus plus is only executed after the increase. Let's show it. Var actually int e is equal to, let's say, 5, and let's say int j is equal to 0. Now we say I is equal to 5, j plus plus. So we have I with 0 now and j with 1 now. Perfect. So the next time we set I is equal to j plus plus. So the next one is called, we have I is 1 and j is 2. Perfectly. Hi, André. I can also perfectly use that atlas ID. So when we save the atlas here, the actual texture of the atlas, we currently use nbr, which is just real quick thrown together increasing number, but we actually have the tree.tree ID. Wonderful. So we always have the atlas ID saved, and we have the atlas with the atlas ID going to be for that atlas. Add a method just real quick, private static list atlas texture. Packed internal pack atlas. It's probably just gonna be the same. Yeah, it's just gonna be the same. I just want to. Close enough. I just want to remove this whole code down here and add a second method for static list atlas texture internal load atlas. Web. I'm fat fingering all the keyboards, key thingies. This also still needs the list. Actually, it doesn't. This one does not need the list, since we'll be checking if we want to load the atlas. If nothing changed, we can just load it, or if we want to create a new atlas. And same with the old atlas creator, we'll be adding a force, so if you want to force it to create. So yeah, internal pack atlas and internal load atlas, and we just check if. And I think, yeah, I've got a method over here, should load from disk. Should load from disk. This one also needs the loaded data. Actually, we probably can just throw in the given data. And load data down there by itself. So the textures may be given, and if we want to load it from disk, we return internal load atlas. In any other case, so if we want to create it, we return internal pack atlas. And in this case, it needs the input textures too. Importantly, if we want to load from disk, should load from disk, and it's not force, so not force, and we should from load from disk. If force is true, this one is always false, which means this the whole line isn't even evaluated. If we use the normal end, only and the left part is false, since the right part cannot be true, only the left part is evaluated. And so if force is true, this one is always false, this side is always false. Since that side is always false, it's always gonna be going to the else and packing the atlas. Just for debugging purposes, let's add some logging, debug.log. Actually, this one already has some logging. This is just the system created atlas. And in this case, debug.log, we do not have some, so we just add some. Debug log loaded atlas from disk. Now, should load from disk. We have the given data. The given data is the data that has been fetched by the mod loader. Now we need to load the data that already exists, if it already exists. So we make sure if file.exists, and let's negate it, add the atlas rects path, we can just return false if there's no file, or not file exists, atlas path, and in this case it will have to be some, we have to do some magic. So the issue is atlas path never exists. This is named atlas. What we have to check is, or what we want to check for is, plus 0.png. Usually I never like doing plus. I always tell everyone, please use path.combine. But in this case, we do not combine anything. We just add something to the name of the thing. So why can we not just check for the atlas? Well, we do not know how many atlases we have. What we know, however, is the first atlas is always going to be 0. So atlas0.png, if atlas0.png does not exist, that means we do not have any atlas. Thus, we do not load any atlas. We can just instantly go to create in one. If there's atlas0.png, we can then go further and load the data and see if the data still is the same. And just to make sure, we want to check if either of them is missing. If we always have to have both the atlas rect JSON and at least one atlas present. If there's no atlas and or the JSON is missing, we cannot rebuild the atlas from disk. So let's load the data. And in this case, we want to deserialize into the same object we deserialized to. It's going to be trees, which is list of tree. And what do we want to load? We want to load file dot read all text. Read all text from the Atlas rect path. Yes, Carl. Actually, no, Carl. The Atlas path is always going to be path.combine application persistent data path. That's the AppData roaming, not AppData roaming, AppData local law. Sim output folder. So this one. And don't look at where I've placed it. It's just going to be the one where your safety and all that stuff is. And we also use the mods folder, and then we just say Atlas. So we just add Atlas. This means it's going to be sim airport folder, and then slash mods slash Atlas. This would work fine on most systems. The most systems don't actually require .png or .anything. Extensions aren't required mostly. But what do we want to see? We want to find the first atlas. So what we do is just add 0.png, and that's our first atlas. Now we have loaded data and given data. Now we do some checks on both. The first check is easy. If either of them is null, we just return false. This means there's some load error we do not want to carry on. We cannot carry on. There's nothing to carry on to. And the rest is pretty much the same as the other one. We check if the count is either zero, if there's nothing in the, on the loaded data. Then we cannot continue. And if the loaded data.count is different to the given data.count. So if there's a difference in the tree count, we also do not want to continue. And this is tree on tree level. Now we also want to check for each tree. Tree in loaded data. Loaded data. So we check each single tree. And this is actually not correct. So the problem is given data is the list of atlas section, but loaded data is always going to be the list of trees we have. So this can't actually be checked anymore. So what we want to say is check if any tree is loaded. And then we want to sum up loaded tree nodes and check if equals given data count. Then gonna make a small handy method for it. The tree always is needed to add a node, which means we always can save the so we currently don't have any remove. The issue is if we okay, let's restart. So what I want to do is, let's say we have a count here. This count is going to be hard. It's not going to calculate recalculate each time, and it's going to have a private set. It's going to be zero by default, and once we add a node, in this case count plus plus, and if result count plus plus, return result. So the point of this is that we have a count on how many textures are on this atlas. There could be a problem if you go down and remove any node manually. But we are not doing this currently. It's not possible. Well, it technically is, but we are not currently doing it, let's say it like that. We probably can do it. Is anything using that? Yes. Ah, never mind. So this one is going to just be private set. And private set. So no, nothing other than the same class can set them. Yep, and that's fine. So there's no way to actually remove the root node. Private set. The only real issue with this is that JSON is gonna have trouble loading it. Let's see. Stack Overflow is probably going to help in this case. Oh well, this is easier than expected. So we want to deserialize this stuff, but we don't want to change it while the at runtime. So we just say, yeah, count to JSON property, and all JSON properties, even if with private setters, will be loaded. So check right. No, please add JSON property. I think that's the way you do attributes over comments. And JSON property. Perfect, all this stuff is not going to be saved. Position, oh, I just noticed this stuff can actually be saved, but we ignore it. We don't need it. Now this can technically be a private setter too. And this can be a private setter. This one is going to be a private setter. I think the Atlas texture is only referenced outside, actually. Yeah, so the Atlas texture is referenced from the outside, so we will not be making it private. All of the other stuff can be private. This means to remove a node, we'd have to make a method for it. But since we don't want to remove anything, we will not be doing the method. And since we cannot remove anything without telling the tree, we will not be, we are fine just counting whenever some node is added to the tree. So why do we note this? This makes the life 10 times easier, because now we can just say if loaded data dot sum, and we look at each tree, so tree t for tree, t dot count, and if this is not equal to given data dot count, we return false. So all of this stuff was a bit long segue, but all of this stuff was just to sum up the load data, which we use Linku for, and compared to the given data. Now, this one is going to be a little bit different. We want to check each texture that is still correct, but we need to check it a little bit different, so I'm going to rewrite it. So we want to check for each tree, we want to check all trees in loaded data. Actually, yeah, loaded data. So I'm doing it the other way around. I'm checking for each given texture here, which actually has to be done. If you check from looking from given text given data, that is the current data, how it's currently what currently is correct, and that is the stuff we want to have. So we have to check from given data. This is a bit of a problem in Drew, since we can't just say load the data any. Load the data is going to be a list of trees. So we have to check over all trees if any of the trees contains the node we are searching for. Let's make our life a little bit easier and say that we have a public bool contains node, and then yeah, we can just say contains node. That's fine too. This is gonna return true. Let's make it really simple. If root is equal to node, return true. Let's make it just. It's not gonna be called too many times, so let's make it lazy. For each var nodes. N in this case, since node is already used up, in get nodes, which needs brackets, if n equals to node, return true. So this is gonna be at best 01 and probably most time 0n, which is fine. I'm gonna leave it here, but I'm actually needing a different method. I actually did a bool any, and in this case it's going to be a predicate. Hey Joy, thanks for playing SimAirport. Today we are doing some programming on SimAirport, so it's gonna be a bit drier. Really nice of you showing by, dropping by, whatever. So today we just do some programming and testing, implementing some modding features in this case. And yeah, that's really it. Might be a bit dry for most, but if you do any programming or modding, that's this stream is going to be. I think what does the USA lit? And yeah, please guys, don't be mad at me for using modern words. I'm just trying to be young. So tree.any is going to take a predicate, which is going to be of type func with the result of bool. And we are the in this first. So we want to check each node for something specific. In this case, we need to give a node, and we want to return a bool if the node is a correct node we are trying to search for. Predicate. So we'll be looping over all nodes again. Node and get nodes. And if the predicate of node is true, we want to return true, and otherwise we want to return false. Now we can say load data. No, we want to say dot select. No, we want to say for email dot any. We want to double dot any it. No, we don't. We want to for each it. but for each is not going to return true or false. So we manually have to for each it, which is fine too. So we take a look at each texture, and for each texture we want to take a look at each tree in loaded data. And we want to look at each tree and see if each tree dot any, so this one, tree dot any node and node dot atlas texture dot path equals to texture dot path and node dot atlas texture dot last file change equals this stuff. If there's any, actually other way around, if there's not any, so if there's one, if you find a given data texture, this one doesn't work actually. So the problem is we want to check if there's none. But in this case we only check for one tree. So we want to check all trees. If there is one, let's just make a method first. It's gonna be easier. Private static bool is on any tree. And we will be giving an atlas texture. And yeah, that's gonna be it. Actually a list of tree too. So the list of tree. And atlas texture, and we just say for each tree in trees, if, and we just copy this one, return true, and so if we find it on any, if one tree contains this atlas texture with this exact path and this exact last file change, we want to return true, it is on one. If we don't find it on any, we want to return false, so it's none. And this makes our life way easier. We can just check if not is on any tree, we load the data on the texture we check. When in this case we return false. So if any of the given data, so the current state, is not on any tree, we want to rebuild the atlas. So now how do we load atlas? How do we load the atlas? We have to do this twice, which we can probably, yeah. Let's just say private. Actually, let's not say that. This is annoying. Yeah, let's actually just use the class scope variable for it. So private static, and actually put it to the privates. Keep your code organized. It's gonna happen in the future. And future is defined by probably tomorrow. Forgetting code is pretty quick one. So private static list of tree loaded data. This is going to be null and it's fine because it's only going to be set first. Rename it, and we'll rename it into a problematic state, since it's still loaded data already exists. but that's fine. Now we use the... We don't declare a new loaded data, we just load it into the class scope variable, which is perfect, because the only time we need it on class, on the whole class, is when we load it from internal. In any other case, so if we have to pack the new atlas, we don't even load it. And in that case it can be null, that's fine. So what do we do if we have to load it from internal? We have to do a few things. For the main part, we have to get a list of atlas texture together. So atlas textures is equal to new list atlas texture. Now we take a look at each tree in loaded data. And we want to do a couple of things. And you want to check each node. Each node of them is a single texture. Tree.getNodes. And for each node, we also have to create a sprite, which is most important. Node.AtlasTexture. Well, actually, first we say atlas texture dot atlas textures dot add node dot atlas texture, and then on the same reference we say sprites create sprite tree dot atlas node dot atlas texture, which is not gonna work. Why is it not gonna work? Because the tree dot atlas is gonna be null. Why is it gonna be null? Because it's not saved. We cannot save a texture to the. This is fine, however, because when we can load it from the disk. How do we load it from disk? Well, let's see. Let's actually fix those names so Jason is gonna be having an easier time loading it. Even though we do not technically have to load this stuff. If the names are pretty equal and just differ by the case, then JSON.NET will actually load it correctly. And it will see, this is the correct constructor for this. The atlas is still not going to be loaded, it's still going to be null. Which is fine, we can just really simply check for a null atlas here, if atlas is equal to null, then we can just say atlas is equal to texture2d dot load nop from nop. How do you load it? Packing. Never mind. It's gonna be atlas is gonna be equal to new texture 2D 2,2 and then the atlas dot load image, and it's just gonna be a byte array which we can easily load using file dot read all bytes, and in which position do we want to load it? We want to load it at sprite.packer.atlas.atlas.path plus the atlas ID plus .png. Perfect, now we have created the sprite. The tree is correctly loaded. This should work fine. fine. Let's see. Create sprite. We need the atlas texture. The atlas texture contains the name. The name is created from the path, so this is saved without problem. The direct is saved. And yeah, that's it. Those two informations are saved, so we are perfectly fine loading it. And I think that's it for loading it. So we just return the list of atlas textures. Perfect, let's say force is false, so we do not want to load from disk if we don't have to. Same over here. So in this case, both atlases should not load from disk. Both atlases should load... sorry, other way around. Both atlases now should load from disk. We shouldn't have a new atlas created. Yep, that didn't go well. So it said new atlas generated. False is false, so should load from atlas from disk. Did not return the correct result. Let's check that both files are correctly existing. Yes, yes. Why did it create? I'm just not gonna ask. Dot save. It accidentally created a second atlas due to it. Which means we probably have to regenerate it. Yes, never mind, it still only saved the new one. So we are fine on that. yeah, let's actually just debug it. Let's see, given data 18 atlas textures with which all have a name and a rect, and that's okay. Yeah, that's fine. The first atlas texture should have a 0.0000. Well, they all have it. That's a problem. Wait, actually, that's no problem. That's the given data. The given data does not have an atlas rect yet. So that's fine. Let's see. You're both false, so let's continue. It's loading. It's not null. It has 1, and 1 has 18 count, so that's perfect. Given data is 18 count 2. Loaded data count is not 0. Loaded data.sum is not evaluable, but must be the same. So let's see if it returns false on any. No, it doesn't. So why are you creating a new atlas? Never mind. It did not load from disk this time. Perfect. No idea why it didn't work the first time, but it apparently worked perfectly fine the second time, and it didn't create a new atlas this time. Let's add the same debugging this stuff has. Ah, yeah, stop debugging before you copy paste something. Mod atlas loaded from disk. Time taken. Is this much? (Clears throat) This is suspiciously fast. Why would it be this fast? Why would the Atlas crater be so slow? This is running crate sprite just like normally. Really, really interesting that this is running way faster than the than the old system, and I'm not completely sure why. Whatever, it's working fine. It's probably working fine. It's loading the Atlas from disk. So let's commit. Okay, last thing to add it. So we have to actually we have to do two things now, and I think then we're done. We have to say that the mod loaders should only use the sprites of the new Atlas. Yeah, currently the sprite we don't use the result of it. Let's say we use the result of it. And don't use the result of this one. Now we have to change mod atlas. Mod atlas currently is a texture to 2D. We have to set it to list of texture 2D, which is going to disrupt a couple of things throughout the code base. But mainly, okay, this one is easier for each. Tree in. Ah, damn, we're not getting the tree actually. So let's say Atlas. Mod Atlases equals to new list. Perfect. We should be fine actually, still. Let's see. Loaded mod texture. So for each texture. Atlas texture. We want to see if mod atlases dot contains atlas texture dot sprite dot texture, and if it doesn't contain, we say mod atlases dot add atlas. Atlas texture dot sprite dot texture. Perfect. Now let's set a breakpoint there. This is should only add the Atlas textures. And I just noticed we pretty much do the same down here, the same list. So we can combine them. Perfect. At the end, we should only have the atlases on the mod atlases list that we need. Since we checked, only if it doesn't exist, we add it. this also automatically disables the old system. Now the issue is everyone depending on this list. was just completely thrown out of the window. Let's see, Floor Ranger. No, it's just seeing the wrong overload. Okay, perfect. This one already supports, I think pretty much the whole game supports multiple atlases already. Since we use more than one atlas in-game anyway. Yes, Jake. The atlas, like you just saw, the atlas texture saves at which time the last file, was last changed. So even if the your texture is of the same name, but you update it, and the last file change is has changed, the mod atlases, actually all mod atlases will be rebuilt. The problem is if you have change the texture, you can technically also change the size, and if the just the texture changes. Then you could argue that maybe you don't actually have to update the whole all of the atlases, but it's easier to just update all of them. And if the size changes, which is also possible, but I can't really detect or have to check out for each time, you have to recreate all of them anyway. So if the file changes or the path changes, atlas will be recreated. So let's see, we want to check all atlases. And for each, actually we want to say atlas, for each atlas in modloader.modAtlases, we want to say git return and then pretty much this one. And then let's add if modloader.atlases. Actually, let's make this a bit simpler. This is gonna still be stdmat and this is gonna be atlas. So there previously there was a check if the mod atlases is null, but we pretty much always just create it as a new list. So let's say there we go, it's equal to new list of that, and we can just make it read only. Just put an issue up for that. It's probably gonna be a bit harder. The issue is that there's no really open dialog or something like the file open or the folder browser dialog like you have in WinForms. So I'd have to manually add some dialog system, and that's gonna be way too costly. The only real thing is we could copy it, but honestly, I don't see why that has to be added. Since if you're making a mod, you need to test it anyway, so you have to have it in your mods folder. And if you have it in your mods folder, it shouldn't be an issue with the uploading. But definitely add an issue for it. So let's see, mod atlas. So this list is never going to be null now. It's always going to be at least an empty list. What does this mean? Does mean that if we for each over this, it's just not going to execute anything. This line is never going to be executed if mod atlas has nothing in content. So that one is fixed. Let's check out next one. This one is fixed. The mod loader references are all good, so it's pretty much just these two. which is just a hash set, which I think has an add range. No, it doesn't. So this is a hash set also already, so we can just say for each var atlas in modloader.atlases and copy paste. That broke it a little, but that's still fine. Paste. Perfect. So there's no add range. The list has add range, but in this case we just manually for each of it and add it. Now let's see if mods work. Or if everything's just going to go haywire and doesn't work. I think if I'm, we actually have. Ah, never mind. I thought we have an issue, but that should be fine. Could you like stop and recompile, please? No. Okay. Cool. Then don't. Chat, is it gonna work? Is it not gonna work? Well, this seems promising. This texture is working fine. Let's see, it should have loaded from disk. Yeah, 1.something seconds. I'm still wondering. Floor. Let's test some other things. Structures. The new hangar mod. Made by mod there. Do we have any other mods? Yay, a bunch of them. The wooden bench. Place it outside. And that's actually it. I don't actually have many more mods. But as you can see, lovely textures. And probably a broken design. Never mind. This is fine. Yeah. This is working out better than expected. And it's actually working. So that's lovely. And yeah, that's all references. Only this sprite manager. And the floor render. Need the references. There's also some references on the loaded textures, like the sprite renderer, as the sprite manager must know all the loaded all the mod textures, but that's still the same. So there's still a list of Atlas textures which we load, or we have loaded, or we packed. That's still the same. So that's not a problem. It's literally just saying we now have several Atlases. Biggest question now is, will it work with multiple atlases? We never tested that yet. So let's real quick commit it again. Actually clean it again. CM updated code to supply multiple atlases. Perfect. Now thanks for joining us, Chick. Always happy to have people on board. And have a good dinner. I'm probably just gonna create some funky big textures and test with that. So I hope to see you next time. And I hope you have a great evening if I'm done with by then. And but you're likely not gonna miss too much while I'm just drawing stuff. Let's see, our atlas is gonna be 4K by 4K, so let's say we want to say exactly have 4K by 4K. Why do we exactly have 4K by 4K? If you have a width of 4096 and a height of 4K, this means that all the small textures still fit on the main on the first atlas, but all the bigger textures Like the hangar mod I made will not fit on this one. And I'm just gonna make some rubbish on this one so we can see where it is. Save that. Quick access mods. Let's just put it into something. Textures. Yeah, this is fine. Big.png. Okay. And drum roll. And it's broken. Mostly broken. Ah, this is bad. Let's see. Did you recreate it? Yes, it did. It took 1.3 seconds, which is fine for two atlases. Let's see. Did you create two? No, it created three. Why did you create three? I can see why. And what the fuck did it do? Why did it copy the existing atlas? Do you see any lines on this one? No, no. Okay, so whatever this is doing issues. The Fuller 70 works fine. Probably this one works. Yeah, this one is gonna be fucked. Let's see. So first interesting note. We have three atlases. Why do we have three atlases? Because when we load atlases, we always have to load the atlases that are on the disk, the atlas JSON, at least. And if we load them, we are increasing the next atlas ID. So we currently have one atlas. Now we load to that one. Now our ID is one. And we noticed that the big picture that has been added, so there was a change. Basically, there was a change, but the problem is this ID was now at one. So the new two atlases that were created, which were perfectly fine created, just not the atlases itself, it's just perfectly fine that the new atlases that were created got ID 1 and 2. So how do we fix this? We say that the atlas ID should be loadable. So let's say private set, and it's going to be the JSON property. And probably not do this. Yeah, let's say atlas ID, which means we can remove this again. Int atlas ID. Atlas ID is equal to atlas ID. Well, that was close. Atlas ID. And whenever we create an atlas, we just say trees dot count plus one. So if there's one atlas in it, trees dot count is one. Our next atlas is actually going to be one since we started zero, so it's just going to be trees dot count. And in this case, it's always going to be zero since it's the first atlas. And then we can remove this set again, since it's actually... Yeah. Since it's loaded by a constructor. JSON.NET should load this fine while using the constructor, so that's fine. And let's remove next atlas ID. Now that should fix the issue with having too many atlases. Thinking about it, Lou, we have one small issue. If we load the atlas, if we do not load the atlas, if we create an atlas, we have to remove all existing atlases. So let's make a private static void remove existing. Let's actually say purge existing atlases. We do not have to do this with the atlas rect path, so the JSON we write. This is always going to be rewritten. So that's fine. If it's empty, we don't care. This is always just going to be overwritten. What we care about is that there's no atlas extra. So if we have want to create, let's say that there must be two atlases, but we only need to create one. In this case, it would just write the atlas 0. And atlas 1 would remain on the system, which we don't need anymore. So remove it. Which is simple, for each file in directory dot get files in atlas path which is going to be an issue, because atlas path is actually already contain atlas. So we want to say path dot combine this one. And we want all atlases gone, which means if file.filename, actually we need to say file.getFileGetName, no. Ah, never mind, it's in path. Path.getFileName of the file punct contains atlas. So we will be also be removing the old atlas at this point. In this case, we'd say file.delete the file. And purge existing. Perfect. Whenever packing a new one, we want to purge all the existing ones, and that's fine. Now we want to load twice. First time we want to see that creating the two atlases still works fine, and the second time loading you want to see that it does not create new atlases. So this time it should have created a new one. Never mind, it did not create a new one since it didn't change. So let's change it. Let's create a new one. Same issues as before, but it actually created it. Let's see, mods. Yeah, perfect. The old atlas is gone and we have atlas 0, which is correct. As you can see, we've got some graphics that still fit on here, on the top, which is perfectly fine. This one's created perfectly fine. The issue is this one. Let's see. First off, why is the texture copied? It shouldn't. We have a node, we add the node to the trees. Actually, this one is an interesting one. We copy texture. The atlas. Ah, yeah, no wonder. We want to copy. We always copy the same. Onto the same. We want to say tree dot atlas. So instead of copying to the current tree atlas we find, we actually just copied. We always copy to the first atlas, which meant this funky stuff happening. We want to actually copy to the tree.atlas, and this is fine. This is fine. Yeah, that should always be fine. Reset the rect, reset the sprite. Yeah, this should work better. Now we have to change it again. Because otherwise it wouldn't load up. So let's just save it. And go. Let's see, yes, it did create a new one. Atlas 0, perfectly fine. Let's close the old ones so we don't see them. Atlas 0, and Atlas 1, and it's exactly the same. That's an issue. Why are you exactly the same? I'm creating a new texture for each tree, correct? Yeah, new tree, atlas, texture 2D, new texture 2D. And I'm also not, I am using this one. So yeah, this is an issue. I have to save the correct one, tree.atlas. This is only ever used for this one, not for anything else. I'm gonna do this, and say this is going to, but that didn't work out. Yeah, yeah, there you go. Perfect, so I cannot accidentally use the wrong variable. What will happen in that case, Carl? Pretty simple, actually. So there's two points that will happen. Number one, once if you want to add a node to the tree, and the node is bigger, it's just gonna throw an exception. But the mod loader is also handling it. So let's see the generate mod detection atlas. If it is, yeah, here you go. If the garbage width is bigger than sprite atlas or height is bigger than sprite atlas, it will just say texture, your texture is too big, please resize it. So it won't split, it will just be ignored. And if you try to manually create atlases with modding, which is technically possible, but harder, in that case it's just gonna reject. It's just gonna throw an exception. Basic man can say no, can say yes to that one. If it's ever coming to PS4, we'll let you know. But currently there is no plan for it. I hope you're still having fun with the PC version. Let me know. It's probably more fun than watching me program some stuff in it. So let's see. Now this, I'm sure this is the correct way to do it. Like this time, it's going to be both atlases are going to be correct. Aha, this is looking better. Let's see. Atlas 0 is perfectly correct. Atlas 1 is perfectly correct. Cool. And it seems as if, yeah, Fluos was correct before. Never mind. This is looking funky in sometimes. No, it's working fine. Ah, I see. Yeah, that's an issue. So this should be work, it should work fine if you're close to it, but it shouldn't. Yeah. I'll have to take a look if that's a problem with graphics copy or just the mipmap level. Let's see if the rest is actually still working. At least. Yeah, it's showing the same issue. But the wooden bench, yeah, should work fine. And if you go far away, it doesn't work fine. So how do we check if this is a mid-map issue? Actually, let's check first. Let's see if the atlas is correctly loaded. Then we check if it's a mid-map issue, or if we can confirm that it is a mid-map issue. If you have graphics issue where it's broken like this, if you are further away, it's probably always a mid-map issue or a level of detail issue, any of the two. So in this case, we want to see this has loaded correctly, this has loaded correctly, and this actually loaded correctly this time too. Let's see if the wooden bench works. Yep. And it seems like this time it works fine. So it's probably gonna be the graphics copy system. And I think I know why. So the issue is we copied the texture. Why is that an issue? Well, it's not technically an issue, but we are doing it wrong. Why are we doing it wrong? We are not setting the correct bitmaps. The game is expecting the atlases to have a specific bitmap, since I think this edge cycle we are using bitmap levels. But we said no, this has no bitmap level. If it has no bitmap level, that's gonna be looking like that. I think bitmap level is currently defined in camera zoom. Let's see. No, it's not. Okay, this is not gonna be the, that's not gonna handle it. Maybe material manager? Ah yeah, perfect. This one is handling mid map level. Okay, perfect. Mid map level is maximum at 4. So we take a look at this and say source element is gonna be 0 still, source mip is gonna be 4. So we want 4 mid map levels. And dest mip is the third last one, this one, is gonna be 4 too. Since this is only happening when we create a new atlas, let's really quickly undo this change, save. And before we introduce any issues, before we truly introduce any bugs, let's really quickly go back to the material manager and actually hardcode this, make the variable. Public static const, public const int can't be static and const, it can only be one of them. In this case we want it to be const, int max mip map level is equal to 4. And since we use it as float, actually we did can just use this, this is fine. Mip max mip map level. Yeah, we use minimum of these two numbers, so if the calculated mipmap level is higher than the max mipmap level, then we use the max mipmap level. So we don't have hard-coded magic numbers in here. Zeros are fine. If we do not use a feature, we don't have to set anything. These two zeros are always fine. They are the source x and y, but this doesn't have to be a magical number. Material manager, that's probably in some namespace. Yeah. Dot max mip map level, and there you go. And let's split it up. Perfect. So we now also convey mip map level. So we want to see a perfect result, like we saw it when we loaded it, just that we want to not load it, actually create it. And we do not have a perfect result. Yeah, that's an issue. With the region not sitting in source element. X, Y, source. That's annoying. Yeah, that's probably the issue we have. We can probably just force it manually. This is only on a render texture. Question is if the texture 2D also has this. As in, we want to first copy it, and once copied, after copying, We want to say probably not Atlas Sprite. Mipmap? Nope. This is all on render texture. Let's see. We either have sprites. That's not helpful. Let's see. Let's see if it correctly works, if we can use destination map, as in if you can, if you just use what the what Unity already loaded up. This copied fine. Never mind, it didn't copy fine. Invalid source. Called with invalid source map level. Got 13 has 13. That is that's equal to me, but okay. If you think so, Unity, then I'm fine. Copy texture. Called with invalid source map. Oh yeah, great. So much help on the web for this one. Let's see if we copy it 1-to-1. Nothing. Hey. Damn, that's actually it. So that's not gonna help. It's copying from a specific map level. Ah, yeah. Okay, this isn't actually too bad. We just have to copy each of the MIP level. So we have to copy 4 MIP level from 0 to material manager dot max MIP level. And we just say copy MIP level to destination MIP level. We only have to copy the ones we actually use, so this is fine. No need to add any more. We should still be regenerating since I forced to true. And this should be this should be working. I hope. Maybe. Let's see. Yep, this is looking pretty good. This is not looking pretty good. Well, it's partially looking good. This texture is working at least. The floor is still working. The hangar is not working. Why does this not fit? Well, first reading it is. Let's try this material manager dot that one. And destination dot mip count. Ah, yes. I requested 4 by default. And I tried to copy anything up to 12. Lovely. Wait, even if did we copy anything to high? Yeah. It's still saying that mid-map level 1 doesn't exist. Just stupid, since it does. It should exist. Hey, Chick is back. So Chick, the current issue is that we are not getting the mipmaps correctly copied for the sprites. I'm not completely sure why. Okay, this is not the one we want to use. Probably this is what we have to do. Let's see. So, texture utils, remove all of this crap again. And say we want to copy no map maps. And in sprite picker, once it copied all of them, let's say that we say tree.atlas. mip maps. What was that function called? Ah, never mind, it's static. No wonder I couldn't find it. Texture2d.generate all mip maps. There you go. Fuck.
That's a static field? Indeed, it is. Select methods, anything to... Nope.
Seems right to me, Chick. Wait a second. Ah, yes. Documentation, great. Da. Is documentation. You see documentation? It tells you what the width is, it tells you what the height is, it tells you what the format is used for. Map chain doesn't apparently exist. Probably the one we have to use. Let's see. As in when we create the Atlas texture, this one. Let's say we want to have this, should be fine. And true. And please, using that one, that looks a bit better. Texture format? This is texture format. No, this is not texture format. Visual Studio, please use the correct one. This one. Texture format seems to be in the same names, but never mind, it's there. Dot. Ah, yes, great. Because I know. I think we just use the default one, the main one. And true. Let's see, let's also add it to here. This shouldn't make it worse, at least. It should only make it better. It should. Let's see. Text array is working. And this one is not working. And yeah, same issue. The map doesn't correctly load. trying out stuff till it works. Since nearly 3 hours. So before writing it, let's say tree.atlas.apply. And yes, please update bitmaps. So we first copy all of it, and then we say we want to apply the maps. By the way, am I generating new ones? No, perfectly. Just needed to check that we are not actually generating new atlases all the time. We want to create new atlases, but we want to not overwrite, but we want to delete the old ones. Object structures. Well, there we go. That's what we searched for. It's working, chat. Look at this. Perfect. Turn it into Atlas 1, 2, this one is on 2, works in all directions, all mipmap levels. Wonderful. We did it. Well, I did it. You looked, which I really appreciate. Lovely. Let's see the bench working. 2. Building mode is working fine. Normal mode is working fine too. Wonderful. We don't need that. We don't need that. We don't need that anymore. I should actually remove it. So, let's see, last check of the day, and I can probably commit it and push and merge. last check of the day is, what does happen if we say bool is false, false is false? This is looking fine, this is perfectly fine. Bench fine? Bench fine too. Zoom levels, perfect. Cool. So we got a working multi-atlas system. We got a working multi-atlas system. It can create as many atlases as we want. We probably have to check at some point how many atlases we can actually use and stop creating new atlases at that point, but currently that's fine. We just make as many atlases as needed. The system is working perfectly fine. It's a little slower than the old one, but loading the atlas I don't know why, but loading the atlas from disk seems way faster. Instead of taking a couple of hundred milliseconds, it now takes a 1 millisecond, 1 point something. Which is really lovely. So loading has been improved by 100 something times. Creating has been slowed down a little. It has been added everywhere, so this should be perfectly fine to use and deploy. I probably deployed, let's real quick commit it. CM finished, let's say just fixed several issues. Multi atlas is now working fine. Yes, Jake, that's exactly the point why we implemented this system. We will never see any compression anymore. Well, but we didn't yet handle one point. Previously, we had one atlas for modding, and if that one atlas is full, it actually broke, as you could see, and we actually don't have to fix that bug, at least, and we can just use a new system. The point is it will scale down. If the multi-atlas system is hitting the atlas maximum for the game, we actually have the problem that we can't add more. It is impossible to add more at that point. We can, even with the multi-atlas system, we cannot add more. But I think we have a couple, at least five or something, like atlases to work with. Which means we are pretty good for the moment. Five atlases, let's see, that's a lot of pixel. I mean, I don't have to calculate it. It's five atlases times 4K by 4K. Which means we have some time to work with. And but yeah, the sad point is once the game has reached the max atlas size, the max atlas count, we cannot add any further atlases. So let's create git checkout edge and git merge. Actually, let's go back. Git checkout stream sprite picker. Let's push this one since it's not pushed yet. And git checkout edge, git merge stream sprite picker. Merged perfectly fine, as expected. And you can see what we did over the stream. And as you can see, it's mostly the sprite picker. So let's push this. Actually, not push it. I want to do one more change. Let's wait for Unity to finish reloading. Actually, let's just say yes to all. Unity might not be completely reloading otherwise. Perfect, we are now on Edge and we have the new sprite picker. Let's go to the Atlas creator and throw it out. It's not used anymore. Let's also remove all the new things we don't need. Wonderful. And rename the file real quick to just Atlas texture. Perfect, cleaned up, old one thrown out, and everything here. Let's see, it should recompile without error. Yep, perfect. Let's clean that one. And say cleaned up old Atlas creator. Perfect, git push. So this is coming to Edge on the next build for you to test out. I'm probably not gonna build tonight. We've now nearly streamed for 3 hours. Thanks for you all guys coming out, and if you're watching this as a video later, thanks for watching. Make sure to like, comment and subscribe, whatever the usual YouTubers are saying. I'm not that deep into YouTube yet. I hope you guys join me on the next stream. Let me real quick take a look at my stream list. Since we're finished with this stream now, actually, it's on C repositories. Perfect stream ideas. We got a huge list of stuff. Where do we have it? I have it somewhere. Yeah, here you go. There you go. Perfect. Mod list updated. We've got a huge list. I'm probably gonna talk to you guys on Discord over the next week which of the project we take up. And we'll be doing the next stream probably next week. At least, yeah, next week should be fine. And we'll be doing one of these topics. I hope I'm gonna try to make the next topics less dry. Thanks for coming by, even if it's, or viewing the video on YouTube, even if it's really, really dry. The issue is implementing a binary tree and checking it out is, or debugging is a bit annoying, a bit dry, at least, not annoying, but dry. And it's hard to make like funny or jokey. But anyways, like I said, thanks for you all coming by. Thanks for watching the video, and I hope to see you next time. Bye bye and good night.